Hi everyone, in this video we are going to look at how to connect cursor, probably one of the most popular IDEs with AI enabled in it after Andrej Karpathy's recent tweet on how cursor and Claude is changing how he programs, right? And our users also have been using it with the JarvisLabs instance. So in this video I want to show you how you can connect cursor to a JarvisLabs GPU instance or a CPU instance and build a small application. Most of the videos available on the YouTube usually show how to build a web application. So I was curious, does it work even if I want to build AI application? So I played around with it for some time, and this video is the outcome of that. So we are starting with a cursor. Now, nothing fancy has been done in this till now. We will go and launch a GPU instance. Let's pick up the most popular PyTorch framework. I'm picking up A5000. And I'll choose a storage of, let's say, 100 GB. It's 110. And let's call it Florence and cursor. Okay, the reason I'm doing Florence is I was working on Florence for one of the previous video. So I wanted to see how quickly we can develop a Gradio app that can probably take an image and output a caption of what the image contains. Florence is a foundational model for vision tasks. It can do a lot of tasks like captioning, object detection, segmentation with text prompts, and it converts to these things. I've made another video on it. If you're interested, please check that video. Let's click on launch instance, and it's going to take less than 4 seconds to launch the instance, so it should be up and running. Yes, it's up and running. So we can connect through this instance using JupyterLab. VS Code, this is online VS Code that comes with the instance. What we will do is we will take the SSH. Basically, you can SSH into this container. But what we are going to do is we are going to use cursor to SSH into this. So when you do it for the first time, you have to install this. In my case, it's already installed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say connect to host, and sometimes you want to clear what is there. So let's go and clear what I have because of a particular issue, how SSH works and the cloud instances. To have a clear idea of it, every time you launch a JarvisLabs instance, we create a new container, and each of these containers have its own fingerprint. So when you try to SSH to the same server, the SSH server is going to think, oh, this has a different fingerprint and it's things as a man in the middle attack. To avoid that, what we usually do is say connect to host and say configure SSH host and go to this and clear any of the entries that you have. This is probably one of the easiest way to make sure that you are able to connect to the host. And now copy, paste whatever you have copied here. From here, I'm clicking this, I'm copying this content and adding it here and say enter. It says open config or connect. Let's say connect. It's going to take some time to connect to the container that we have created. And it's also going to install VS Code on that particular server. The reason it installs VS Code is cursor is built on the open VS Code variant. There are a lot of things that are built on top of that. So that's the reason cursor is now going and installing it. Let's wait for a few seconds. It's opening a remote connection and now we are up. How do we know we are up? Let's do ls-al. We see these things. Let's create a directory called Florence demo, right? Let's go here and let's go to the JupyterLab and let's see if it's getting reflected. I did a refresh. Yes, we're able to successfully connect to the machine and we're able to talk to it. Now let's open the folder that we have created, Florence demo, and say okay. Now what we'll do is we'll say command key, which is basically to talk to the Claude inside cursor. What we will do is write a Gradio application. Gradio is an open source application which helps you to build quickly UI in pure Python. It was an independent company. It got acquired by Hugging Faces, and all the Hugging Face spaces is built using primarily Gradio. They also use something more like Streamlit and more, right? But in this case, let's do a demo on Gradio. Write a Gradio demo which accepts image as an input and spits a caption. of the image, right? Not just that, to create the caption, we want certain function, right? We want to use specifically the Florence 2 model to create the caption. Let's use Florence 2 model, okay? So the problem with working on AI, the latest projects, is the Claude model may not be aware of Florence 2 because it got released a few months back. So what we will do is kind of use a fancy concept called RAG. Let's say Florence, and I already have searched for it, so it's there, Microsoft Florence 2. What we will do is we will go and probably take this or go to files and versions. There is a sample notebook here. We'll look into it. Actually, I did this in my previous video. That's why I'm aware of it. Let's copy these things and say that use this to generate the new function. Let's say example code. This is basically your retrieval augmented generation. Just that I'm doing it manually. If you can have probably a database where you can go and search for what content you want, get that content automatically, then you call it RAG. This is also a simple version of RAG. I think I have enough information. Let's say enter. Let's see what happens. It's generating some code. And this is all happening using Claude 3.5 Sonnet. Right. Now what we'll do is, sometimes Cursor gives a way to create files for this, but I'm not able to get it today. There is a GitHub issue that's already running, and some people have posted that it's occurring for them. I'm not sure if this is specific to SSH. When I did something like a web UI application, it works, but for AI applications, I did not find it working. But it's a small comfort. Let's not get too comfortable. Let's create a main.py file and add the contents to this, right? And it, first time when you do it, you have to install the Python extension for Cursor. Let that get installed. And we have some of the things that we need to install, like Radio, Torch, Transformers, Pillow. This instance already comes with some of that. So what we'll do is, we'll say, create requirements.txt with all the required requirements. Let's wait. Let's open this and say accept all. See, now it worked. We did not create the requirements.txt, but it has created all the things. It has requirements. I'm not sure about the requirements. So let me just remove those things. I don't want hard coded because I may have some of these already in the instance. We can actually save the minimum version required, but in this case, I'm not really worried about it. So let's close this for a moment. Let's hope this works. And okay, it still needs this. Let's try to see which one we want to use. We wanted this particular environment. This is where everything gets installed. Okay, we did not install. We just created the requirements.txt, all right? Pip install -r requirements.txt. It's going to install any of the missing libraries which we don't have already in the container. It's going to take some time. Okay, it's done. Now what we'll try to do is, let's assume that this is super smart and launch Python main.py. Something is happening. Okay, request the following package. Okay, it needs few more libraries. So let's take these things, basically Transformers library or something from Hugging Face is telling that we need these three things. And they also have a nice error saying that we need to add these three things. Let's add them. Of course, you want them in separate lines. Tab, this is what Cursor again helped us. Now let's go and say, install it again. Flash attention could take a little bit of time because it has to do the building wheels. Let's wait for a few more seconds. Okay, we have it now. Let's see if we have the Gradio app running. I didn't even check the code. Let's go and check the code also. So it says iface.launch, gradio.interface. It's calling the function generate caption. Generate caption. task prompt. I don't think it's going to work. If you've seen my previous video, you'll know why it will not work. But let's wait. So when you run it for the first time, it's going to download all the required libraries. Now we have it running, Gradio. And we're able to check this in the browser. Now let's upload an image. Oh, not sure what happened. Let's close this and say drop image here. Okay, it's working now. Let's say submit. Okay, as expected, it's not generating a caption. The reason is Claude does not know how this works, right? The task prompt should not be this, but it should be this special word called caption. Okay, or caption will give a very small description. Let's kill this and run it again. I think it did not get killed properly, so let's run it now. It should not be taking that much time. Okay, we have it ready. Let's open in browser. Let's upload the image again. Hopefully this time it works. Say submit. A man holding a sign that says find and flux LoRa easy. That's not what it says, but it's got more or less. What we can see is something like detailed caption, or I think this also works, more detailed caption if you want a very big one. I think there's a way to have this reload rather than changing it every time, but let's not worry about it right now. Okay, say open in browser. Let's upload the same image which says JarvisLabs is the best. If you've been using JarvisLabs and if you find something not working properly, please let us know. Now, as you can see in the detailed caption, it has got a much more better in detail. The image shows a young man holding a sign that reads JarvisLabs is the best. He's wearing a black t-shirt and has a beard. The background is bright yellow color, blah, 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 right? I have not built a Gradio application other than the Hello World. It's really amazing how you can use these AI tools to build something simple in probably less than 5 or 10 minutes. It'll be interesting to see. I have been using Cursor even for building JarvisLabs, but that's since it's not from scratch. I was not able to use like the entire file because it's complicated. It's not, but for building something super simple or not very simple, probably mid complexity, you can have it create most of the boilerplate code, a lot of things. I think for projects like UI, it's much more helpful. I hope you found this video useful. If you want more such videos, please let us know in the comments on what topics you want, or find anything challenging in JarvisLabs, please let us know in the Discord channel. Don't forget to join our Discord channel and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.